Hey everyone, this is going to be a bit of an odd video because we're talking about the Nintendo Switch Lite, a system I don't own. Now, it is a system I have used, it is a system I have touched, but I've had three of these bad boys in my house, and that's what I'm going with. Now, I am considering buying a Switch Lite for my one of my children, but the thing is there's a lot of merits to the question. Is the Switch Lite actually a good system, or is it even good in comparison to this Switch? Yes, you can't dock it. We all know that's a feature not included. But I'm not talking about the ability. Just as a handheld system, a portable system, is it good in comparison to what the alternative is, which is this big boy Nintendo Switch, which might be a bit, you know, unseemly, say, for people with smaller hands. Now, I have monster hands. I mean, look at this. I can practically touch, you know, the back of my hands together while I'm holding the Switch. But the thing is, the Switch Lite wouldn't be for somebody like me. It would be intended more for, say, my 5-year-old or my 7-year-old or even my 10-year-old. It wouldn't necessarily be intended for me. Now, we've seen advertisements of college students using it and everything, but I think we can agree that's probably not the typical use case, although I'm sure there's plenty of adults out there that happen to own a Switch Lite. You might even own both of them. Now, what made me start to question this isn't just my own experiences with Switch Lite. It's actually a post put up on Reset Era by a member named Garrison, where he actually severely regrets buying a Switch Lite. And I find his reasons for it quite interesting, because I feel like the reasons he has for it are the same reasons that you should just not like a Switch in general. And it makes me wonder if people are misunderstanding the system a little, but also, is there something that's just, in particular, even worse about the Switch Lite in comparison to the Switch? Before I get into this, I am giving away a Nintendo Switch, or a PlayStation 5, or an Xbox Series X. Details on that down in the description or the pinned comment. Alright, let's get into this post. So, Garrison says, yesterday I found myself selling my Nintendo Switch Lite for some store credit at GameStop. Something that I haven't done ever on account of just being unhappy with a system. And I'm just perplexed at all the wrong things Nintendo got so wrong with the system. Within the last 2 years, I've come to regain my love of portable gaming more than ever, thanks to being on the go more than inside the house. Even with the pandemic that started last year, which made a lot of us stay home a lot more, it did not matter to me, as I enjoy going around in the house and playing everywhere, next to the wife while she watches TV, outside on the balcony, etc. I was expecting what I've always liked about Nintendo portables with this one. Having a system that feels great in the hands. Okay. The great Nintendo software to play along with great games from other publishers here and there. But this thing just fails by all accounts. What's even more surprising to me is how in the hell, as was YouTube, games media, and other internet raving about this system. The Switch Lite is still probably the only system you would most likely find at stores available more than other systems, and I get it that people are rightfully looking for the proper Switch console. But I now know why. These two points I have been I'm going to talk about repeatedly, but I will detail them here. The problem with this system is not that it has a few problems. You know, every system has those. You know, things like lack of themes or whatever the case might be. The main issue I have with the system is it really doesn't do anything well. Like, literally nothing. I'm surprised Nintendo put this thing out, to be honest. It's the worst system they have put out since the Virtual Boy. It's a rather lofty claim. But has enjoyed success out of being a lower cash accessible Switch, I guess. It has the worst ergonomics of any handheld out there by a major game company ever. This thing is just trash. Reaching the top buttons while changing from the analog stick to the D-pad was probably something that no one ever tried before sending this thing to the manufacturer. I own a Game Boy Advance, a PSP Go, a PS Vita, a 3DS, and a DS Lite, and every single one of these has better ergonomics. I kind of agree with that, by the way. Most people's solutions involve putting large grips on it. Yes, there are grip solutions out there for this that fix it. Which is to say, what's the point? Just get the regular Switch. Here's the thing. When people say, oh, the solution to the Switch Lite grip issue, because it legitimately has, it's not that comfortable to hold, is get the regular Switch. This has the same issue. Just because the controllers are a little bit bigger, a little bit taller, doesn't fix that problem. It's still kind of uncomfortable when you're holding it, because he's basically talking about, you're holding it, you know, and this is going to look weird this way, but basically where you're moving your thumb from here down to the D-pad, and how uncomfortable it is to keep your fingers on the top triggers. So as you move your thumb down, it's kind of weird to keep your finger. It just doesn't feel. It feels cramped using the D-pad while keeping your fingers up here. And that is an issue that's even slightly worse, obviously, on a Switch Lite, where there's even less space. So it's kind of a weird decision Nintendo made, and it definitely doesn't feel that good. Now, there are solutions out there, of course, some excellent solutions that make the Switch, you know, really comfortable to hold, but it's a problem on this Switch, too. So it's not really just a Switch Lite issue. Ergonomics has been an issue with Switch from day one, and it's kind of funny too because Nintendo's own grip for this system fixes the ergonomic issues that exist with the Joy-Con on their own. So it's like Nintendo knew there was ergonomic issues and just didn't care. Kind of interesting on that front. All right, the next complaint he has is that the screen is way too small for the content that you play on the system. What I got from this thing was more eye strain than entertainment. You could tell publishers don't give two craps about portable mode, and even Nintendo themselves half-ass it. Last thing I tried was the Monster Hunter demo, and reading the text alone will put your eyesight to the test. Nintendo had way more screen space available on this thing. He's talking about the bezels, of course. Would be playing instead. They opted to put some big effing bezels on it and cheap out. Like, at least you know everyone is going to do big TV games on it and make them actually as playable as possible. So this is an issue with this Switch as well. Now, this screen is huge, okay? In comparison to the Switch Lite, it's pretty big. Nintendo's official dimensions, I have this right here. This Switch is 4 inches high, 9.4 inches long, and 0.55 inches deep. With the Joy-Cons attached, whereas the Switch Lite is only 3.6 inches high, so just a little bit, you know, shorter. So it's like right here, but it's only 8.2 inches. So you lose an inch, 1.2 inches, which is like this much. You know, basically the Switch Lite's like this in comparison, and because of that, the screen size goes from where it's right here more like down to like right here. So I guess let's go diagonal. So if you're at the diagonal here, it kind of shrinks into like, I can't get my fingers exactly right. So it shrinks into about right there. Now, that technically is, in terms of Nintendo portables, the second biggest portable screen Nintendo's ever had. It's still bigger than the new Nintendo 3DS, than the XL version, etc. It's still bigger than that. So it's not a tiny screen. The problem is, a lot of games, Monster Hunter Rise is one of those offenders right now. The text is just really hard to read, and I'll admit, one of my issues when I tried Monster Hunter Rise, right after I read that post, I fired it up on Switch. In fact, I'll try to fire it up here for you guys, because it's going to be hard to see in portable mode. But the text is just really small. And because the text is so small in this game, it can be really difficult to read. Now, I tend to do okay ever since I got contacts, but even then, I find myself squinting at times to read text in some games. And it's very clear that many games are not designed with the portable aspect in mind. And that's kind of a shame that games aren't designed that way by default. Because when they're not designed that way, it creates a poor experience in portable mode. Essentially, you can tell that while Nintendo has touted the Switch as a home console first, that even with the Switch Lite, it's very clear the Switch, and at least the games made for it, are made with the home console approach. They are made for your TV first, made for the portable second. Now, he does mention that Nintendo games are offenders of this too, and then brings up Monster Hunter Rise. Monster Hunter Rise notably is not made by Nintendo. I would have preferred him to mention something Nintendo related. Now, I haven't had any issues with Nintendo text. Maybe a couple things in Xenoblade that would have been maybe a nice example. And I'm sure you guys could think of hundreds of examples of games that have poor text. I mean, this initial text isn't that bad when it's just talking about the demo. But it's when you're in-game. It's the in-game text that's the issue, not the menu text and like the warning text and how many tries are left on the demo. Like, this is all fine. But then you get into the actual game here, and I'll get this loaded up here and hopefully show you. The text can be hard to read. I mean, even here, this is already not the greatest experience. And even now, I'm noticing on a normal Switch, as soon as I go to use the D-pad, look where my finger is. It's off the triggers because it's just not comfortable to put it up here. So I think the issue that we're going to have, and I'm just going to load up one thing I've already done in this game, in single player, just load up a basic character here, is that the Switch Lite is basically exasperating all the issues the Switch has. The Switch has terrible ergonomics. The Switch, a lot of games made for the Switch are not made for, you know, people with little. I mean, look at this. I don't know how well this is going to show up. You know, the camera kind of focuses the way it wants. And I'll try to get a closer up look that someone else probably did. But like the text is pretty tiny and not easy to read in some regards. I could tell that it says M Prime Nate up in the corner, but this is also on a bigger screen. This is going to be an even bigger issue. Like I could barely tell about the L and Y buttons down to use potions. That's not good. And that's before you even talk to anybody. Cause I know there's a person you could talk to, or maybe not in this part of the game, maybe it's just a demo part that does that, but, it's wild, just absolutely wild. As I'm now getting distracted by Monster Hunter. The point is that I feel like the Switch Lite calling it a bad system is really just saying it's the Switch. It has the Joy-Con drift issue, except they're not called drift or not called Joy-Cons. It still has the drift issue. Same design control sticks. It's basically has every problem that this system has, except it's a little bit worse. As in, the text is a little bit smaller when it was already too small. So the text in minigames is even smaller. The ergonomics that are already terrible on the system are even worse. And, it also doesn't have the TV mode feature, which is something you should know going into buying it, that it's not going to work on your TV. But still, it's like you're giving up all of that for a worse experience. So you could say, yes, go buy this Switch if you're just going to play it on TV. Hook it up to your TV, take the Joy-Cons off, put them in the grip, the Joy-Con grip, and it's a much better experience. Or buy the Pro Controller, which I modified mine with RGB, but point is, go buy a Pro Controller or something. Or a Power A controller, or whatever you want to use with your Switch. There's adapters out there. You can use your Xbox or PlayStation controllers with it as well. The thing is that I question what the purpose of the Switch Lite was until I just look at, you know, as you look at Nintendo's comparison, handheld only, no tabletop, no, there's no, they didn't put a kickstand on it, even though you can hook up other Joy-Con to it. It's got slightly better battery life, even than the Model 2 Switch. It's got slightly better battery life, all that jazz. Okay. But then you see the price point. And it starts to come into mind why the Switch Lite exists. Okay. This was debated about a year ago. The whole reason the Switch Lite exists is to be an entry point into the Switch systems. If you don't plan to ever play in anything but handheld, this doesn't offer really a better experience than the Switch Lite does. If you're worried about ergonomics, this thing sucks too. And you're going to be buying a grip. Okay? There are some amazing ones out there that are stupid expensive. There's also some cheap ones out there that'll get you by. You know, the Satisfy grip comes to mind as one that's just widely popular, super comfortable, and they make it for the Switch Lite, and they make it for this. And what's cool about making it for the Switch Lite is the Switch Lite's not a system you're going to be putting in a dock. So you could just leave the dang grip on there all the time and not worry about it. There's also certain cases that have slightly better grips that offer, say, like a folding flap that'll cover and protect your screen. So I'm left sitting here, I'm wondering, to anyone complaining about a Switch Lite, do you know anything about the Switch before you bought it? The Switch is a great system. It has great games. It offers great functionality. This model Switch offers amazing functionality from you to go from docked mode to portable mode to tabletop mode. Play a wide variety of home console games on the go, plus getting the, you know, handheld games and making them even better, like Pokemon. Although, you know, Sword and Shield being better is, I guess, obviously, you know, subjective and everything. But we still have Pokemon games that at least visually look better than we've seen Pokemon games look in the past. We're seeing an evolution of gaming to a point where Switch is becoming, for some people, maybe their favorite platform ever created. But the Switch has had problems from day one, and those problems have never been solved. And a lot of us have been waiting for the Switch Pro, hoping that some things would get solved. Obviously, Joy-Con drift has been a lot of coverage, but yeah, this thing's not very ergonomic. Even for me, I can get my hands a little tired playing this for longer sessions because it's just not that comfortable. Now, when I'm at home, which is where I game a majority of the time, I end up playing with a docked and playing with a pro controller. So I don't notice the issues as much because I admittedly don't play in handheld as much as I once did, say 2 years ago. Now that my home studio is all set up, I play a lot more down here because I'm always recording footage or live streaming, which is not a normal use case, of course. Most of you people aren't content creators worrying about that kind of stuff or thinking, hey, look, even if I'm just playing for fun, I might as well record the footage because I might potentially need this in a future video. You guys don't play games like that or worry about that kind of stuff like I do. But I'll just say this. If you're thinking about getting a Switch, this is absolutely the best thing you can get. This is the version 2 Redbox Switch. It's back there on the shelf. One of those three Switch boxes there. One of them is the Redbox version. That's what this is. It's a little dirty. My Joy-Cons are kind of beat up for my kids. My kids did a number on this one. But it's the better system. But also, if you're never going to play in TV mode, never going to play in tabletop mode, you should just buy a Switch Lite. Because the issues you might have with the ergonomics, the issues you might have with the small text are always going to be there. The small text issues, by the way, do not put that on Nintendo. I want to make this clear. When text is too small on a system that has a portable screen like this, you know whose fault that is? The publisher, or really the developer, for not optimizing their game for handheld mode. They should. Nintendo optimizes almost all of their games for handheld mode. So don't put like Monster Hunter Rise on Nintendo. Don't put other third-party games on Nintendo. If there's issues with Doom Eternal, if there's issues with other games in portable mode, guess what? That is on those companies. It's not Nintendo's fault. So I can't call that a flaw of the Switch Lite or even the Switch when it's not Nintendo's fault that companies don't optimize for it. Now, when it comes to things like the ergonomics, guess what? You're going to hate it on this too if you hate it on the Lite, and you're going to need to get something like a Satisfy Grip anyways. So personally, get the Switch Lite if you only ever plan to play in handheld mode and you are willing to buy a case that has a grip on it or just an extra grip for it. In fact, there's a few grips I could suggest for the Switch Lite or the Nintendo Switch. I'll put Amazon affiliate links down in the description for those. Ones that I have personal experience with and think are amazing, Satisfy Grip included. Which, if you don't know what that is, there's a billion reviews of Satisfy Grips out there. But they're also on the higher end, and they sell specialized cases for them and everything. So you don't have to go that high end. There's cheaper ones out there. They don't feel quite as good, but feel a lot better than by itself. So to answer the question that I posed in the title of the video, is the Switch Lite a bad Switch system? Yes and no. It's bad in that it exasperates issues that already exist on the original Switch. But then it's also not because it's only $200. And if you never plan to play in TV mode, I mean, you get a bigger screen. But probably the bigger screen is not as portable. So you pay $200 for a more portable system that still has a pretty big screen in comparison to any other portable out there besides the original Switch. You're going to deal with small text issues because that's an issue portables have always had when games aren't properly designed for it. And hey, yeah, it's not very ergonomic and there's already solutions out there for that. This isn't the solution to ergonomics. So yes, it is bad in that it exasperates current issues with the original Switch. But it's also good in that it's only $200. And as an entry point for kids, I can't suggest the Switch Lite enough for children. I really can't. I have three children of my own. One of them two of them have actually owned three boxes back there. Two of them have owned a big boy Switch. One of them got their Switch stolen. Sad world we live in that someone would steal a child's Switch, but I'm sure it was another child who stole it. Things happen. My daughter has the older version Switch, and like she enjoys it. And yeah, my kids like taking the Joy-Cons off, but honestly, I have another kid of mine that prefers to play with the Joy-Cons attached and wouldn't even be able to tell you the difference between the Switch Lite and the Switch. because they play it in handheld mode only anyways. So I don't know. I think that there's a lot of pros and cons to all of this. There always has been. I just think it's an interesting conversation to have as we sit here in 2021 and throughout 2020 as we realize the Switch Lite is a more readily available system for a reason. People want TV mode. People want the ability to use a pro controller comfortably with a TV. But at the same point, there is, I think, a market for Switch Lite. And that market is, I think, mostly kids and people with smaller hands and people that want handheld only and don't want to pay $100 extra for a dock and features that they're never going to use, like detachable Joy-Cons. So you win some, you lose some. Switch Lite is basically all the issues of Switch, but smaller with no TV mode. Take it for what it is. All right, folks. I'm Nathaniel Robojanis from Nintendo Prime. Here's hoping that a revision is in the works, a Switch Pro that'll fix some of these, or even a next-gen Switch in 2 to 3 years that could see better ergonomics, no bezel, better screen technology, better battery life, better everything across the board, I think, would be expected for next-gen. So we've been waiting a while for Nintendo to address some of these concerns. They haven't yet. So we just have to hope a revision or a brand new system does it. All right, folks. Thank you so much for tuning in. I'm so sorry if you heard some of my children in the background. They're playing in the other room. It happens. Life of a parent. It is what it is. I'll catch you guys in the next video.